Hello and welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. And today we're going to look at a new set of updates across Microsoft 365 ProPlus and Windows 10 to really make it simpler to deploy, from new tools to help you with add-in app compat and advanced configuration options at install time, optimizing network traffic updates, and new ways to understand and plan the best path forward with tailored recommendations using the IT roadmap that we just saw. So today I'm joined by Amesh Mansukhani from the Office 365 engineering team. Welcome.
Thanks, Jeremy. Great to be here, as always.
All right. So we're constantly updating our Office clients, and we're finding new ways to plan and deploy client deployments and upgrades. So what's the team been working on to make Office deployment even better?
Well, we focused really on three things based off our customer feedback, right? We're looking at install time configuration, application compatibility, and network efficiencies for updates.
So what are we doing in terms of, let's have a look at some of the things that we're doing, actually. So in terms of the three things that we are actually focusing the most on, let's start with install time configuration, because I know that we've done a lot in the past in terms of maybe granularity of control on other package types. But for click to run now, we're doing a lot more in terms of giving you more granularity. So let's start with install time config, then we'll move on to app compat and network efficiency.
That sounds great. Yeah, so for configuration, we've really had controls in place to configure Office 365 ProPlus, right? We've had that for a good amount of time now. Then we focused on doing the installation, configuration change, and update management through System Center Configuration Manager. But today, we're now going to be introducing the Office customization tool for click to run. This is the one that you've known and loved for a long time around MSI. So we're introducing that now for our subscription product.
Did you just say the Office customization tool for click to run?
I did, you know.
Oh, come on. This has been something that we've been asking for. People have been asking for a while now, but I know this is awesome. Can you give us a quick look about what it does?
Yeah, I definitely can. So as you can see here, we have a nice rich UI that allows you to start customizing exactly, you know, what kind of configurations you want during install time. On your left-hand side, you're going to see a nice little navigation around software, application settings. These are your preferences that you've set in the previous OCT. Mm-hmm. And then you have installation updates and licensing. And in your middle area is kind of where you start your configuration. But the thing that we're really introducing here that's new for folks is on the right-hand pane, you can start seeing that customization, you know, really be generated in layman's terms, right? So if I start saying, okay, what's the organization name? I'm going to go with Contoso. I'm going to add that. I'm going to say I'm going to want 64-bit. And you could see on the right-hand side, we start updating that directly in the pane itself. And now I have the ability to look at the actual suites that I want. We're supporting exactly what you're seeing in the Office deployment tool in Microsoft Intune, as well as System Center Configuration Manager.
So consistent with the things like the CSP, for example, that you might use with a mobile device management suite.
That's correct.
So very cool. But you've also done some other work in terms of, and one of the most requested features, sorry, I've got a lot of background here because I actually managed kind of the implementation of all this initially. Match OS is another capability that we're bringing back, right?
Match OS, we are bringing that back. Now that gives you the ability to actually look at what OSs you have on, what language packs you have on the operating system, and then start matching it directly on there and taking it from your source file. The other thing we're also going to be introducing is this ability to fall back to the CDN. So we keep getting asked for smaller package size being delivered to multiple locations, where we now can say, hey, I want to be able to take one language file, distribute that across my organization, and then fall back for all the other languages directly from the CDN.
That's awesome. So, and you've also done some work in terms of making sure that you can initiate the deployment through Microsoft Intune as well, right?
That's correct. So let me switch over to that, and I'll show you exactly what that looks like. So this is the Intune portal today. And so we started because we know a lot of folks are now moving over to the modern management, right? How can you actually take things like Autopilot and then be able to provision off Windows, and then shortly after that, install Office? So that's what we started with, where we now can go into the Intune console. We can go into the mobile apps and start creating my first set of applications. And we introduced a new software type here where we're calling Office 365 ProPlus, right? So you can add that in here. And similar to the Office customization tool or the ODT, I can select things like what applications I want to exclude, what languages do I want, and as well as the bitness. So once I have that configured, I can start targeting those devices that are being managed directly by Intune.
Very cool. So beyond all of that, I think that a lot of people think about application compatibility and how I kind of go from one version. Maybe I'm on Office 2010 or some other build, or maybe I want to go from one semi-annual update to another. Are we doing anything there to help?
You know, we certainly are. We're doing quite a few things around that. So the first thing that we did is we introduced the ability to get a full inventory of add-ins within your organization. We've gotten so much feedback that, you know, admins are certainly aware of what they've purchased and what they've initially installed, but since it's been multiple years, we know organizations and business units have gone out and created new sets of macros or purchased new add-ins. So how do you know what your entire organization looks like? So the first thing we did is with the upgrade readiness in the Windows Analytics, we actually provide you that full list of add-ins in addition to all of the hardware and software that you have in upgrade readiness.
And this is great. So if you detect something that maybe might not be working from a telemetry perspective that we're showing that report of, it gives you nice reports about how many people have that add-in installed. You can then basically prioritize if there's only two or three people with that add-in, it's not going to block the deployment. But if half of the organization has it, you're going to look at it, see maybe if it's an in-house one, recode or make any changes there. If it's third party, see if there's an updated version, et cetera. And that gives you all of that information at your fingertips. And it's easier than some of the older constructs where you deploy, say, an agent, have that log back to telemetry. And this does all of that using the same telemetry infrastructure that the rest of Windows uses for device upgrade.
That's correct. Yeah. So, but now for those of you who are not delivering your telemetry and you going through upgrade readiness, we actually just introduced the Windows Readiness Toolkit. We just announced that several days ago here at Ignite. And basically what this does for you is it allows you to quickly scan your environment and go, okay, what kind of add-ins do I actually have within that? And in this example, we see we have 16 unique add-ins, but four of them we actually need to go and assess. Now we have some additional smarts that was actually telling us the insights that, hey, we know the rest of them are going to be pretty good, but we have some stuff in here. And we go into the granular details as to which apps do we have, what versions, and how highly adopted they are. But we just didn't stop there, right? We started working with the readyforwindows.com website and starting added the add-in functionality into that website as well. Now, let me look at one that's fairly popular. I'm just going to actually go fairly generic too and say PDF, right? What this tells you here is it's going to go and search, and I clicked on the Office add-in section. Okay. It tells me PDF Architect 4 Word, if I had this particular one, what version is actually highly adopted across the 64-bit? So I can look at 64 or 32-bit against a target version of Windows.
Very cool. So let's go back, though. You mentioned also this is the app compat. We've covered kind of the install time config that we can do now. And by the way, we've had System Center Configuration Manager integration for about a year, so we didn't cover that or show that at this point. But hopefully you guys are using that today. Why don't we talk about network efficiency? Because we've changed the update model quite a bit in terms of how Office updates are delivered. It's consistent with what we're doing in terms of Windows updating as well, right? So we've got the semi-annual channel, and we've also got the quality updates that we do monthly. So how would I prepare then for, say, a semi-annual channel update? What do the sizes look like? What are we doing there in terms of network efficiency?
Yeah, so network efficiency has certainly been a big thing that customers have been asking us about. So we did a couple of different things. One, we looked at the overall package size. We just cracked those open, and we said, how can we optimize those for better, to be much more network friendly? And so what we did is we found a lot of areas that we really could be efficient at, and we took advantage of that, right? So if you're going from a features standpoint for in the semi-annual channel, we've reduced that from approximately 600 megs down to about 350. So you can expect that as you're starting to plan your overall rollouts for those who are adopting semi-annual channel. But as you go from a month-to-month basis in the semi-annual channel, you'll have about 100 megs that you would have to be taking from there. So those are your security updates that we're actually delivering there. But if you're for those of you who are on the monthly channel, you can expect anywhere going from about 300 megs down to about 100 to 150 megs is kind of what we're informing these days. And we're starting to continue, or we're continuing to improve that over time.
And are we doing anything in terms of like branch cache or peer caching to support the update delivery?
Yeah, we actually are. So the first thing that we've done is we worked with System Center Configuration Manager to actually integrate into their peer-to-peer. And the really nice thing about that, it's really easy to set up, and if I have a management point nearby, I can set up in devices that I can designate as a peer device. That okay. Now if I want an update, it will go to that particular peer device and be able to get the update directly from that. And if it's from two computers, it'll actually go to both computers.
All right, can we see where that's configured?
Yeah, I'll certainly show you that. So essentially, if we go into System Center Configuration Manager, this is available from 1706 onwards in technical preview, and will be out shortly. But it's really simple. I go into administration, I have my client settings, and I can open up or create a new customization pane. And the setting itself, if I can get this open, oh, my VM's not being too cooperative. But if you can imagine with me, I have a little configuration pane here. And all I'll have to do is just turn it on and say, yes, I want to be able to use my OS as a distribution point, and then be able to target those clients to be able to support that capability.
Very cool. So a lot of people watching, they might have been a while since they've done their last major upgrade from, say, to Windows 7, or coming from an older platform of the operating system in Office. Are we doing anything to really help with that planning process then, to make it easier for folks to plan their upgrades and kind of the capabilities they want to do?
Well, Jeremy, there's a great new tool for you that you might have heard of, right? It's the OIT Roadmap, right?
Yes.
It basically lets you look at what you have running now and determine what you want in place. And then it gives you a plan of what you need to implement to get there.
Right, so we can see here, if we look at the IT roadmap, and this basically has that four-level continuum where I can say, what level am I at now? I can pick the things that apply to me in terms of how I'm doing device imaging, if I'm going to take my standard apps or my productivity applications, and maybe users have permissions to install them at a very basic level, because Office 365 ProPlus has that capability, but in a lot of cases, they're going to be standard users and not have the privilege requirements there, up to where devices are re-imaged and they've got their productivity applications on them as part of maybe a task sequence deployment. Then as I move to level 3 or level 4, then automation starts to get a bit cooler, where we can do things like auto-enrollment, like you just talked about with MDM, along with, if we get maybe a new device, using autopilot for that kind of initial out-of-box experience setup. So we can actually see on the continuum where we might want to go. Let's say we want to get autopilot running. It's going to then push out a bunch of recommendations that I can look at in terms of some of the tools I'm going to need. So you can see here, user state migration tool, config manager options, et cetera, that I'm going to use along that continuum of getting better and better in terms of the sophistication and the type of deployment tools and processes I can use. So we've got a nice model there in terms of the four different stages, if you will, just around the provisioning side. And on management, this is where it gets also interesting from an app and OS perspective. Here we can say, like, how do I get to the point where I can take monthly updates, or I can take semi-annual updates? Because I might be just used to doing only security and then service packs, and I need to get into more of the semi-annual flow. Then we have all the different capabilities there also mapped out along that four-level continuum. So another great resource, hopefully, that you can use in terms of being able to set up these plans and make sure that you have the right capabilities in place. Let me just give you the link for that, because I actually just corrected the destination of that link, which is aka.ms/itroadmaptool, or you can use transform.microsoft.com/itroadmap to get to it, which was the direct link I should have used in the last session. So just a couple of tools. This is a pretty big set of updates in terms of ProPlus deployment. Where can people go in terms of if they've got questions or want more deployment help?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, we're constantly delivering a lot of information out of the blogs, the Office blogs, as well as the tech community forums.
Right, and also go to Fast Track. Fast Track's a great resource. We had a great show on this a little bit earlier in the week, where you can actually use free deployment help for a lot of organizations that qualify to get That's Office right. 365 ProPlus deployed. They'll use tools like the IT Roadmap, the updated Office customization tool once it's ready to help get all the deployments in place. If you've got Config Manager, if you're using Intune, all those things are things that they've seen and can help you with on the deployment of Office. So thanks, MS, for joining us today, and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for all the updates to Office 365 ProPlus and more, and we'll see you next time.